Did you know that some Milwaukee M18 batteries have a secret diagnostic feature? If you hold down the button, you will get flashcodes with the number of flashes representing a number. The first code is battery status and is only ever ones and zeros. So far, the first and last bits are always opposite each other, the second bit seems tied to the battery and never changes, and the third bit is always zero. We'll torture the battery later to see if we can change that. The second code is day since first charge. The third code is number of charges. Milwaukee has been pretty lazy with what they count as a charge, which may have resulted in this particular battery getting 9,999 charges. This fourth code is a bit of a mystery, but it seems to be a manufacturing ID, maybe to ID the factory or quality control. I've sourced codes from 32 different batteries, but I need your help to give me more codes so that we can figure it out. This video came about because of a tools and stuff video where he accidentally triggered this diagnostic mode. After I left a comment about that, he sent me some codes from his other batteries, and in the space of an evening, we'd figured most of it out. He has a brand new state-of-the-art forge battery with some interesting codes, so make sure to check out his video. Now, not all M18 batteries have these diagnostics. There's about a 6-year window from 2015 to 2021 where Milwaukee seems to have disabled this feature. If you have batteries that fall into these grey areas, let me know in the comments. These are all the codes I've gathered so far. Most came from a helpful Redditor, but I also got a bunch from Bolter Down Under, who is a very underappreciated channel that tests rotary hammers, so check his channel out. Sorting by the fourth code shows little correlation with date of manufacture or battery type. For example, 256 spans a 2-year time period, 3 different battery types, and batteries from Canada and New Zealand. My best guess is that it's an ID for a factory or similar. Some interesting numbers here are a couple of batteries with more than 10 years since their first charge, and a couple of batteries with over 1,000 charge cycles. The biggest standout here is this 6 amp hour that's less than a year old and has 9,999 charges, which is at least 46 charges per day and probably more. This high number could be to do with how Milwaukee counts charge cycles. Looking at the status code shows the second bit might be to do with battery health or age. Every battery made after April 2014 has the second bit as 1, whilst every battery from before then has it as 0. The only exception is this 2 amp hour from November 2013. Now, to torture my batteries and see if we can get some error codes. You can still get diagnostics while the tool is running, but nothing really happens, the codes don't change. Doing the old 4.7 kilo-ohm resistor trick to force it into overheat status doesn't change any of the codes either, which is quite surprising. Running the battery flat on a tool switches the first and last status bits, but running the battery down to 5 volts on a load tester did not change any of the codes. When I repeated the test with the J2 pin activated, then the status bits do switch, just like when discharged on a tool. I don't have time in this video, but if you want to understand what the J2 pin does, check out my video 005. These diagnostics don't work when the battery is on the charger, and if you start the diagnostics before putting it on the charger, they just stop. Now, here's where it gets really dumb. Every time you put the battery on a charger, it increases the charge count. If I put it on and off a few times, each of those increases the charge counter. If you put an overheated battery on the charger, it also counts as a charge, despite not doing any charging. Even putting a full battery on also counts as a charge. This is pretty lazy programming by Milwaukee. They really should only count a charge when it adds at least 20% capacity. Now, if you quickly flick power on and off on the charger, then it won't increase the charge count. But any power interruption more than about half a second will increase the charge count. So be careful if you leave your batteries on a charger, especially if it's in a work vehicle or anywhere where the power is interrupted a lot. However, if your battery is sitting there at full charge, the charger can handle up to 20 seconds of power interrupt. All of these shorter interrupts didn't increase the counter. Now I need your help to narrow down the date ranges and figure out unknown parts of the code. If you have a battery that fits into these grey areas, let me know in the comments if it produces flash codes or not. You can get the manufacture date from the middle numbers of the serial number. On older batteries, you'll need to comment the heat stamp near the terminals. If you do get flash codes, then please comment below in the following format. I'm especially interested in faulty batteries, and if you can find a battery that has a 1 in the third bit of the status code. Finally, don't forget to check out Tools and Stuff video, which should be right here. He's got a brand new Forge battery that shows the same dumb charge counting.